Hi, I'm Dan Margalit.
I'm Isaiah Williams.
And we're answering your
most frequently asked questions about mathematics.
Hi, I'm Dan Margalit.
I'm Isaiah Williams.
And we're answering your most frequently asked questions about mathematics. Oh, I knew that's what I was going to say. Why is that so hard? Do you have an answer for that?
Sometimes math can be really hard kind of because of like the fragmented ways it's taught. You learn one subject and then you jump to another subject before you start to see a lot of the really beautiful ways math can come together, like all the different areas.
That's a good point. I mean, if I can jump in, there's a point of view. There's an essay called Mathematician's Lament about how if you were to design a system for teaching math that would squash out any amount of excitement on the behalf of children, you could not design anything better than what we generally do in America, which is a sad thing to say, but I'm saying it. And you know, like it's like with tennis, right? In math, it's like teaching how to hold the racket and then how to move the racket. Like you just want to like start hitting the ball, which is a shame. I think we should be introducing more exciting things earlier in the math curriculum.
Why does every number raised to the power of 0 equal 1? I've got a question first to you.
Yeah.
So what's 0 to the 0?
Oh, what is 0 to the 0? I think isn't it 1? Or is it's undefined, isn't it?
Depends who you ask.
Oh man, you tricked me. I think there's a good answer to this. We want all of our rules to be consistent and make sense. One of our rules is, well, let's just think about it, right? Let's do like 3 cubed, that's 27, 3 times 3 times 3, right? How do we get to 3 squared? That's 9. Well, we just divided by 3, and then 3 to the first power, that's 3, we divide by 3 again. So then just following the pattern, 3 to the 0 would then be 1, we divide by 3 again, and then 3 to the negative 1 would be 1/3. So you see how this whole pattern going all the way not just with 0, but with negative numbers as the exponents, you get this very nice pattern.
Good. We forgot
the high five. We owe each other a couple. Yeah, and one more. All right. Can you just go in the back and make like 5 more of these? Yeah, because we're just having a good time. How does math help you in life? What do you think?
It's been a real source of inspiration for me. Thinking about math problems and doing math, it's been a way for me to find like community here at Vanderbilt, dive deep into a subject and kind of explore what it has to offer.
Yeah, I mean, math has certainly done a lot for me. You know, like you, it's my job and it's what I love to do. It also helps me kind of in a practical sense. Moving, I don't know, I had to switch legs around on some piece of furniture, so I had to switch them in some order and I started to think about group theory. You know, what's the minimum number of ways I can switch the legs? Because I didn't want the thing to fall over while I was doing this. Or if I'm like crossing the street and thinking about like what's the safest route that's still gonna get me there quickly, I'm thinking about the differential equation which describes the danger from the oncoming cars. You know, I just feel like it sounds crazy, but I use all this math as just a context for like how I go about my business and my day and just the way I interact with the world. Is that weird? How does math relate to the real world? There's so many ways. This is such a big question. You've stumped us, this is your fault. Short answer, like basically in every way possible. You know, everything from like the Google algorithm that when you type in a search like this, it spits out the answer. That's linear algebra. The growth, expansion of the universe, whether it's gonna rip apart or crunch back together, that's partial differential equations. A third one would be, you know, even something like political science, like we study whether a map has been gerrymandered by using combinatorics and group theory and other things like that and geometry. So I could go on and on and on, but you look at anything in the world, there's math there, you just have to find it. How'd that go? Was that after all that?
After all that, that was a good one.
Yes, thank you.
Yeah.